Now it's time for Charting Futures. Here's Abigail Doolittle. And Abigail, I mean, the major averages, I mean, they've been in record highs earlier, but barely moving now.
You're right about that, Caroline. We are looking at lackluster trading action for the major averages. But on the year, it's a different story. We have a big bull run here for the futures on the year. Take a look at that. The S&P 500 futures now up more than 20% on the year. This is the Fed has become more dovish. There's hope perhaps around trade on pace right now for the best year since 2013. The NASDAQ futures and the Russell 2000, not all that far behind. In fact, the NASDAQ futures you can see up even more, but the best year since 2017. But everybody wants to know what's next. Is this a bull trap or is there more to go? Let's take a look at a chart we've been looking at for some time. It goes back about a year and a half. And what's amazing over this time period, we've been in a sideways trend, a battle between the bulls and the bears, a lack of conviction on both sides around these various issues, the Fed and trade that I was just mentioning. We've been looking at it over the last month and a half, talking about the fact that the index is confirmed for 30.60, but this overall area traditionally, historically, is a bearish pattern, suggesting we may see a drop back down into the range. Maybe even the range breaks to the downside. To talk more about this, I'd like to bring in Tom Thornton of Telemetry, Hedge Fund Telemetry in Greenwich, Connecticut. And Tom, thank you so much for joining us. The last time you were on, you had a call where you're actually kind of bearish, very yep. bearish on stock futures, but in September. So do you agree with that chart?
Absolutely, and now I'm actually a little bit more bearish. There are some more upside exhaustion signals from DeMarc on daily and weekly, and that's really, really a rare occurrence.
Okay, so you would be sticking with that options trade. Yeah. Let's bring in a new trade into the idea. And this is kind of interesting because crude oil, this is also a risk asset, typically trades with stocks, but you're somewhat bearish, or excuse me, bullish
I'm
on
bullish,
crude oil.
Yes. How about that? Yes, I think that crude could move above those April highs into wave three. And the RSI here is not completely overbought and it still has room to go. It's around 57 right now. I think we can get above 70 on the RSI and move this thing a little higher.
And you were talking about some fundamental macro issues that supported your idea.
Yeah, you've had the storm, Tropical Storm Barry has gone through. Rigs were down, but refineries are still working. So you should have a big draw this week again. You've had several. Also, you know, the tension in Iran, the Straits of Hormuz, that's a risk.
So you're a buyer of crude futures right up until about 80 or so, but of course we can buy and trade futures through the options market.
Yep.
So you have a great trade here, a bullish trade on oil going long basically through the options.
Yeah, I like the 60 and a half strike September expiration. You're gonna pay around $1.57, mm-hmm. and I think that's a good way to define your risk.